Cristo Rey Podcast. The Cristo Rey Podcast. Coming at you. A podcast. The Cristo Rey Podcast. The Cristo Rey Podcast. Almost to the dream. Welcome back from spring break. It was great having a whole week off. Quarter three is clearly in the rear view. Have you noticed little changes all around the school? Like the barriers at the crosswalk and the mural outside the locker rooms. Painted by Miss Carson, Miss Truitt, and Justin Hamley. Paints a fest.
Podcast. Cristo Rey Podcast. The Cristo Rey Podcast. Right in your ears. Podcast. Cristo Rey Podcast. The Cristo Rey Podcast.
Oh boy, here it comes.
Welcome back, Cristo Rey family, to another episode of the podcast. I'm your host, Jay Sean, and I'm here with my three other co-hosts.
Emily.
Liam.
Vivian.
And welcome back from spring break. I hope that everyone had a nice time, was able to relax and kind of rest your mind so that we can focus for this last quarter. And yeah, it's great to have everyone back.
I mean, it's great to be back, you know. Spring break is a great time for anybody, not just like a senior, but like freshmen, teachers, and everybody to just take a second and relax, you know. You know, it's just, it's like third quarter, you know what I mean? Like, that's, it's a lot. It can get a lot.
I'm not the happiest that spring break is over, personally. I would have liked to rest more. I don't like all the schoolwork that's going to be coming.
Yeah. It's always a lot when you come back from break and stuff.
Yeah, it's funny because I told myself that I was going to do a lot more productive things during spring break, but I just ended up laying down.
I am glad that we're almost done with the school year, though. That's nice. I'm excited for sophomore year. I've heard that sophomore year is better than freshman year.
No.
People have told me.
Like, the people who say that are people who have been going to school because of, like, COVID and stuff. You came back, like, everything is now open. Like, we're not doing, like, online classes or anything like that. So, like, you're having an actual freshman experience. Yeah. So, and I mean that, and I don't mean that like to diminish all the other freshman experiences. Me and Jay Sean, our freshman year is like, we didn't even walk into the school our first day. We logged onto Zoom and we did Zoom classes like the entire day. It was pretty bad, to be honest with you. But like, you cannot say that because then you're going to jinx yourself and then it's going to just be bad. Like, I said the same thing in like my sophomore year, no offense to Mr. Corrigan, but that A push class was really kicking my butt. So like I would not say that. I wouldn't say that.
I also jinxed myself. I said, oh, it's gonna be just like freshman year. No, the work is a lot more, especially like
that's because you're taking like 8 AP classes, right?
8. I can only take 1.
Okay. Well, I will say, now, don't get me wrong, it's not impossible, but at least in my opinion, I felt like freshman year was kind of more of a review and the brush up on topics that you may have reviewed in middle school. But sophomore year, that's when you get introduced to all these new concepts and learning. So I definitely wouldn't rush it. And I mean, everyone's different, but a lot of my friends, when we transitioned to sophomore year, our free time got significantly lower. So I definitely wouldn't rush freshman year.
Okay.
But we kind of just scared you into sophomore year, but it'll be fun. Just in short,
fear is a great teacher. I don't know if it's a quote from somebody, but my grandfather,
yeah,
he'd always
though.
Say that.
No, but I heard that though. It's probably a quote.
Greetings, Cougars. This is Mr. Patrick, and I wanted to take a moment to congratulate you all on completing the third quarter. Your hard work and dedication to your studies does not go unnoticed. And on behalf of Cristo Rey's faculty and staff, I want to tell you how proud we are of all of you. Keep up the good work and know that we are all here for you, no matter what.
Hello, Cougars. This is Mrs. Pettit. I'd like to congratulate you on a strong finish to the third quarter and just tell you that I'm looking forward to beginning this fourth quarter with you all. I'm really proud of all the work that you've been doing. And just as we begin this fourth quarter, our last quarter together for this school year, I'd like to encourage you to keep working hard, keep staying involved with different activities in sports, go to the sports games. Let's all be together this last quarter and enjoy this time together. Special note to our seniors, as you finish your last quarter here with us at Cristo Rey, We all are rooting for you and wishing you the best as you prepare for your next journey. And I just want to encourage you especially to really treasure this time that you have together. So thank you so much, Cougars.
Viva Cristo Rey.
So guys, what are y'all's current goals for this last quarter?
Survive.
That is so real.
Try to graduate, bro.
Maybe like end on a good note, like grades, like with grades and stuff. Like try to get them the best as I can and like end strong.
That's such a freshman thing to say though. You know, just try to make sure I end up on a good note with the teachers and grades and all that.
How's that just such a freshman thing to say?
Because like when you're a freshman, you're thinking like, nah, I gotta get good grades now, and then if I get good grades now, I'm gonna have that mentality with good grades for like the rest of the years. I'm not trying to diminish like what you just said. I'm just saying like that is, because I would think the same thing. In freshman year, I thought the same thing. You know, like I thought if I ended like on a grade note, it's gonna get better and better.
I was just saying what my teachers used to say.
It's been a lot more of a struggle after freshman year, because I had the exact same mentality, and now I'm like, I'm struggling to keep what I was going for after freshman year.
But
I'm not looking forward to finals.
I don't think anybody is. I mean, we don't have to do finals as seniors as long as you do good in your classes.
And wait, even with real? Our AP exams, we get exempt. Like,
yeah, so for AP exams, so for AP classes, you get exempt from finals because your final is the AP exam.
You can still choose to take it.
Yeah, like you can still choose to take it if you want to, but you don't have to.
It's a grade boost. Like if you have like, if you're teetering on like an A and you want to get the A, you can take the test and chance getting an A.
I love how you said teetering on an A and not saying like, oh, if you're failing the class, you can take the.
That's just because from personal experience with me.
So, and then for seniors, as long as you're passing all of your other classes with B's and A's, you don't have to take your finals.
Yeah.
Okay, I can't wait to be a senior if that's the case.
No, don't say that.
Knock on wood, I'm cursing myself.
Wait, all your classes with B's and A's? So, like, say you have one.
There's two classes, but they're AP classes, so I don't have to take the final either way.
I think the only way you can get out of taking the exam if you don't have A or B is AP. Disclaimer, guys, don't think about skipping your finals. It's not condoned. Be here, be present, be fully engaged. We're trauma bonding right now, so.
Yeah. Don't skip out of them because they're very important to your grades, and they're very important to making sure that you can either do your final if you just did your midterm, or you can go on to the next class and you don't have to take summer classes. Because let's be honest, nobody wants to be here during the summer. No offense to all the teachers.
Hey guys, it's Elmer. Recently, I was able to attend Miami University. We toured around and had a pretty broad experience of what it's like to be in college, what courses we're gonna take and everything. And we also got a little explanation about backgrounds about Miami University and their different things that they do. And there's this course that they have as well, which is pretty cool. The director of Miami University, who built the university, made this seal out in the middle of the campus where he found it disrespectful if anybody stepped on it. Nowadays, they respect that seal, and they say nowadays, whoever steps on the seal has bad luck and will fail their next exam. So they have to run on the other side of the campus, and they have to touch all of these golden turtles, rub them each one to reverse the curse, which was really interesting and was, to be honest, my highlight of the trip. But as well, sophomores went on their college trip as well, and we have a sophomore here to talk about that as well.
Hello, I'm Brandon, class of 2026. Recently, we went to two colleges. One was OSU and the other one was Ohio Wesleyan University. They were both really good colleges, to be honest. I enjoyed both of them. The good things about OSU, I feel like I enjoyed personally, was like the big campus. It's like everybody like has their own way, their own schedules and everything. They have like a big campus where you can walk around, many places to go to. And Ohio Wesleyan is also another good college, I'd say, for me, but I'm still deciding. But it's like a more closed campus, and everybody like gets to know each other more. Everybody, like, you meet like most of the people around you because it's such like a small campus where you can bump like into anybody. And I enjoyed these two college campuses.
Thank you for joining us.
Yep.
In terms of quarter four, I'm looking forward to a lot of things. I know it's just beginning, but actually shortly we'll probably be talking about AP review for some exams for those who take AP classes. Prom is really approaching around the corner.
You guys
few
excited?
Weeks from now.
Yeah.
I am.
Are you guys going with anybody?
I do not.
Okay. Got a date, Sean?
I don't.
No, I don't got a date either.
No. Most of us seniors, we don't have dates. I think it's just going to be more like friends.
Yeah, I don't think.
As long as you guys are fun, that's the goal.
Yeah.
Like, my dad is a DJ, and he says that next homecoming, he'll DJ, and he'll do it for a way less price.
Well, for you guys, so.
That's nice.
That's good for you guys, though.
Yeah, I'm glad you guys are seniors. Yeah. You're not going to be here.
Ooh, and I just realized, because since this is your freshman year, is it called the Spring Fest?
Oh, yeah.
Right. Yeah, it's Spring Fest. Spring Fest.
You'll have your first Spring Fest. We've only had one. I wish we had another one.
Yeah.
But like, you're gonna
love it. Last year?
What's the Spring Fest?
It's basically like a field day. So
it's a competition between advisories for like a wacky Olympics type thing.
And we won our sophomore year. Mr. Corrigan's advisory.
Do you get anything if you win?
Yeah, so there's like many different types of trophies. The year that me and Jay Sean won in Mr. Corrigan's advisory, we got the bronze toilet seat. And it's actually in Mr. Corrigan's classroom if you ever want to go see it. He'll proudly talk to you about it and boast about all of his students who won it for him.
Our group so should have won last year. We were partnered with a group who took third and we typically did better than them on events. I was like, how did we lose?
And I will tell you this. There's one thing to be excited for when you become a junior or senior. On that Spring Fest day, juniors and seniors get to go to Kings Island for the entire day.
Oh yeah, I heard about that.
But ours got cut out short.
Because it was raining.
I think it was Mr. Maxwell's room where he has it written down on the board.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Wait, doesn't the physics class also go to like Kings
for
Island?
For juniors.
Yeah, juniors and seniors.
Okay, so for juniors, you have to do a physics worksheet. But for seniors, it's optional for your science class.
Physics traumatized me. Love Miss Lester though. Physics just.
I am nervous. We had a meeting about CCP physics. Everybody who was invited, and she's like, "I don't want any of you in this room taking regular physics next year. I do not want to allow this. You're either taking honors or CCP." And I'm like, "Oh no."
Oh, what are the options? Because we can only take one AP class.
Oh, sophomore year. Yeah, you can only take AP.
And you said like physics and stuff.
So I'll break it down for you. So for freshman year, your schedule is set, obviously. You got your schedule when you came in. Sophomore year, you get the option of having regular U.S. history or AP U.S. history with Mr. Corrigan. And then you can choose to do double math. Instead of doing just geometry.
No, I'm good at math, thankfully. It's
not bad.
It's not that bad. Yeah.
I'm bad at math, so I promise.
Attention. Attention. We interrupt this broadcast for an important message from your Cristo Rey Columbus math teachers. No one is bad at math. I repeat, no one is bad at math. There are only those who have not had a lot of math experience. See you in your next math class, where mathematical experiences await.
And so the double math that includes geometry and honors algebra at the junior level, so honors algebra 2, and that sets you up to take AP calculus in senior year. And so then in your junior year, you have the option of taking AP government with Miss Alimas if you'd like to do that, or regular government. For students who took heritage Spanish, they can take AP Spanish as well, AP Spanish Language and Culture. I took that class with Miss Castillo. It was actually really fun. I liked it. And the other one is AP English and Language.
Yep.
Am I correct? Yes. AP English Language.
And who teaches that?
Miss Wilkins.
Okay.
So those are your options.
So this is a question about honors classes. So like, do I like do anything towards college application?
So the grade.
Mayana said I have to take AP US History or else.
That's
whoa.
Not gonna.
Okay. Whoa. Have to take.
Like no, that's, like that's the only. She said since that's the only AP, that's the only thing college will care about.
That's well, you not don't true. Have that's to, not but true. I will say the thing is, like especially when you do at this school get into more advanced classes. Some of your basic classes in previous years kind of determine if you're eligible for
classes. Yeah, I'm sure teachers will come to your classrooms. I'm sure Mr. Corrigan's like gonna have like a presentation or something, because that's what he did for us. He had a presentation talking about the AP US history course and how it breaks it down. And most teachers who have AP classes, they do that and they break down.
My friends wanna do it, but I've heard it's so hard.
I mean, you can do it, it's just, it's a huge paradigm shift for freshman year. It's very difficult, to say the least.
Well, let me say, because I don't want to deter you away from AP, it can be difficult at first, but actually, and it's even been statistically proven that taking AP classes can actually enhance your learning. And like I said, of course, the first time doing everything is going to be difficult, but like, for instance, like when I was in A push in sophomore year, it was difficult, but now I'm so used to the flow of AP classes, it's honestly not as difficult as it was. So it's going to be difficult at first, but the challenge is good and it will cause you to grow. So don't be completely turned away from AP classes, because they're very beneficial, and when you put in the work, it's worth it. It's just with AP, it requires kind of like an extra level of work and like academic focus
and effort.
Hey guys, it's your girl Icy here. March is Women's History Month. If you are a senior woman heading off to college soon to major in a science field, here are some step-by-step advice from Mrs. Ballman.
Number one, do research in undergrad. As soon as you can find a lab to work in, get hands-on experience with research and presenting research and posters. Number two, find a mentor, someone in the field who you respect and who treats you with respect, someone who will support your education journey and advise you on the way. Number three, be involved in an extracurricular that is a brain break from your major. And four, connect with classmates, form study groups, and be a collaborator. STEM major classes can be beyond challenging, but having a study group that also functions as a support group can keep you committed to doing the work and make it more fun.
Say, like, instead of AP, say it took, like, honors English.
So regular classes are graded on a 4.0 scale, up to a 4.0. APs are up to 5, and honors are 4.5. So it'll raise your GPA if you take honors classes, and it'll still be, and it'll help make you eligible for more AP classes. Like, for CCP Physics, you had to get recommended by a teacher to go to the meeting. I got recommended by two teachers. I got recommended by my honors algebra 2 teacher because I took double math, and my honors chemistry teacher.
Yeah,
because
Ms. Deuce says I should take honors English, so.
And also,
that's really nice.
And also, too, I mean, really just in general, every class you take will matter in college. A little difference is that sometimes AP can kind of boost the colleges and, like, the range of colleges you can apply to, but really inherently all classes you take will matter. And also, too, being well-rounded, that's another important thing. Even if you might not take the most APs, if you're well-rounded, that'll fill in for that, you know? So, yes, AP can give you a boost academically. Every class is really just as important. Like, there's a lot of general classes that still hold really just as much weight as the APs, even though grade-wise, it doesn't.
Like, honors chemistry is regarded as one of the hardest classes in high school, and it's not an AP. But it would still get looked at like it was an AP to some because of its difficulty.
Okay.
Yeah, so really every class, I'd say, has a high level of importance in terms of college and your future. But also being well-rounded and being involved in like community and service, those are also important aspects as well.
Hi guys, it's Paris. Right before spring break, the entire Cristo Rey community celebrated Mass at St. Joseph Cathedral. Afterwards, Cristo Rey Columbus presented the annual Milk Shot Award. The Milk Shot Award is the highest honor that Cristo Rey Columbus can bestow upon a person who has significantly contributed to our school community. This year's recipient was the McCurdy family. Dave McCurdy of the McCurdy family served on the Cristo Rey Columbus board for many years and was instrumental in securing work-study partners and major donors. The McCurdys and their company, Kimball Midwest, are also founding work-study partners. Congratulations, and thank you for everything you've done for Cristo Rey.
You get to, like, plan your classes for college, right?
College is a little different, so, like,
Are you excited to do that?
I'm very excited. I'm looking forward to college. I'm not trying to rush my senior year, but I feel like
It's towards the end, though.
Yeah, well, that's why it's bittersweet, because I don't want to leave the people, but I'm looking forward to the new doors and opportunities that I'm hopefully going to be blessed with. But in terms of freshman year, I believe it's similar to high school where you have general courses, but the difference is your courses from freshman and up is dependent on your major. So like for instance,
medical science. You take biology and anatomy and all of that. You wouldn't necessarily take like humanities.
Yeah, like you probably, especially as you move up in classes, you wouldn't have the same courses as someone that's doing economics. Like as you go up and you become more specific in your major or your future goals, your schedule's going to change. But most colleges, they'll work with you for your schedule. So also too, versus high school, like we're here about 8 hours a day and it's like 8 hours straight. But in college, you'll have specific hours of the day and specific days to where you'll have classes. So you might have like, I'm just throwing this out there, you might have like two or three biology classes throughout the whole week versus here, you'd obviously take it every day of the week.
I've heard like some people do like their college classes like all morning or like all the afternoon. And if you could do that, which one would you do?
For me personally, I'd want a variety. Like I'd want a few in the morning and maybe a few in the evening. So then I have time throughout the day to do different things. So like, I love working out personally and I wanna do a sport eventually. So I would wanna make time to do working out maybe in the morning or evening. And then maybe towards the night, I can dedicate that towards like studying, socializing with friends. And this is just hypothetical because I still haven't gotten to college yet. So I don't know what my schedule will be, but realistically, I'd probably wanna evenly spread it out so I have multiple times throughout the day to do different things.
Hey guys, it's Jade. On March 1st, there was an internship fair at the library. Here's a recap of it. There were a bunch of different organizations and companies there. We got to talk and see different internship programs, different summer positions, jobs, and etc. We got to expand our knowledge and just really connect with a lot of different businesses outside of Cristo Rey's network, which was really fun and cool. There were a lot of different people there and it was a really good networking event.
And I believe the homework supplements the classwork, so instead of going every day, you'd have homework that you would do. Yeah, like
you'd have a syllabus.
And you'd get a lot of your coursework. You'd get probably a textbook that'd be pretty big that you'd probably have to read so many pages of by the class. It's more free in how the classes work. Because the classes aren't set schedule.
That's closer for you than it is to me.
And
that's tough.
You're also more independent as well. So like, and I'm not saying that you should do this. This is purely just an example in this scenario. But like, you know how we have to be here in our classes. Technically, if you're at a college lecture, it's completely up to you. But however, in most cases, professors aren't going to hold your hand either. And even though high school, they don't hold your hand as much as, let's say, elementary, college is even higher. Like, if you miss a lecture, that's on you. And you're going to have to be responsible for, you know, making that up. And if you have a problem, you have to go to the professor. Not saying they don't care, but it's now it's like you're an adult. You're responsible for that. So whatever choices you make, that's completely on you.
Are you kind of scared for that?
Not really. I'm actually excited for it because I feel like it's challenging me to be better as a person, like even with my time management, having structure, you know, forming healthy habits. I'm actually excited to
I just feel like having like that opportunity of choice is like, I don't know, slightly scary, because like in high school you go to each of your classes, right? Because your parents expect you to, your friends expect you to, and you have to, right, to get into college.
Yeah.
But when you're in college, it's like, technically, if you wanted to, you could just sleep in and miss a class.
I mean, if you really...
It's not recommended.
Not people, that's advice for everyone listening.
You shouldn't do that, but I'm just saying, there are people who will straight up go, I'm tired, I'm going to sleep in and miss this class. You can't do that in high school. Like, you would have the choice to do that there.
Yeah.
And that's kind of scary, because it's like, for some people, they would. They don't have their parents to make them go.
Hi guys, it's Nishan. March 25th is the Feast of the Annunciation. Here's Miss O'Connell to explain what that means.
God has been promising for centuries that he would send a Messiah, and this feast day celebrates the day God finally does what he says he would do. This is the day when the angel Gabriel appears to Mary and tells her she would conceive a son and name him Jesus. I've always been struck by the fact that even when God comes down and does the job himself, he doesn't just wave his hand to make everything better. He doesn't descend from heaven as a fully grown adult with a perfect capacity for public speaking and writing. He isn't performing flashy miracles from the sky. In case you didn't notice, March 25th is 9 months before Christmas. This means that God took the time to live and grow as a human. He had to learn to speak. He had to learn to read and write. He had to learn how to memorize the Hebrew scriptures, just like the other Jewish boys. This tells me a few things about God. First, that he is patient. He knows how to wait for the proper moment, which is something I definitely struggle with. This also tells me that he does not take the easy route. Instead of waving his hand to make everything better, he takes on all the sufferings and joys that are part of human life. Furthermore, he allows himself to feel very real pain and sorrow. He endures being crucified. This also tells me a few things about being human. First, that God thinks we're worth his time and effort, which is always a humbling experience. But mostly, it tells me that God wants to work with me, not for me. He isn't going to make my choices for me. He isn't going to do my job for me. He isn't going to live my life for me. Instead, he invites me to participate in what he's doing. He also isn't going to tell me what to do and then just leave me alone. He's right there beside me, in all of my own joys and sorrows. We have a God who understands perfectly what it means to be human, because he's walked the walk. To celebrate this special day, when God announced that he was going to become human in order to fulfill all of his promises, take a few moments to think about what God is doing in your life today. Not just the big picture, but what joys or sorrows are you living through at this very moment? It doesn't matter if it feels too big for you or too small for God. He's lived through it, and he wants to live it with you.
Thanks, Ms. O'Connell. Of course, not only are Catholics celebrating that important feast day next week, but this week is also the last week in Lent before Holy Week. Ms. O'Connell, could you give us another reflection as we begin to bring Lent to a close?
Catholics have a prayer called Stations of the Cross, which we use to remember different moments from the Gospels that describe the suffering Jesus endured when he was crucified. One of those moments is when he sees his mom. If I'm honest, sometimes remembering the Station of the Cross makes me pretty angry. Mostly, I'm angry at Jesus for putting his mom through watching her son die, even if he's that son. When I was younger, a friend of mine got into an accident and lost her leg. I remember feeling helpless and frustrated. I remember how angry I was at God for allowing this to happen to my friend. I still feel echoes of these emotions, especially when I think about what it must have been like for Mary to watch Jesus drag a cross up a hill to die. When we think about Lent and about Jesus dying for us, it's easy to stop with what our head knows about the facts. Jesus was put on trial, Jesus suffered, Jesus died for me, Jesus loves me. Maybe we hear these things so often it sounds empty or repetitive now. It is a lot more difficult for our hearts to understand what it means for someone we care about to suffer for us. Eventually, I was able to make peace with my relationship with God. I wish it was a simple light bulb moment where I understood everything perfectly and God came down with an airtight explanation for why my friend was so severely hurt. But that's not what happened. Instead, my heart had to understand what I was feeling for my friend, the helplessness and frustration, the wishing that there was something I could do to fix it or make it better, the care and concern I felt for her and her family. These were all things that God feels for me. When God watches me make terrible choices, when God watches me in the lowest moments of my life, when God sees people hurting me or sees me hurting other people, he wants to step in and fix it. The thing is, he won't do so without my permission. He will not violate the dignity of having free will. So take a step back this Friday and give God permission to change your heart. Allow him to show you what it means for Jesus to choose to suffer and to die for you specifically, for you personally. And then may the God of peace be with you always.
Thank you, Ms. O'Connell. In her reflection, Ms. O'Connell mentioned the Stations of the Cross. Be sure to listen to the podcast next Friday for our version of the ancient tradition too.
And also too, keep in mind, it's your money. So they're going to be like, I mean, if you want to waste your money, that's for you, you know, to go through with. But at the end of the day, really, you're only hurting yourself. And they figure since you're an adult now, whatever choice you make, now, don't get me wrong. Now, things happen and they're still people too. So if you just communicate and be like, I'm sorry, for some reason I couldn't do this, yada, 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 you know, I'm sure they'll work with you, but in terms of hand holding, is definitely, they don't really hold your hand at all. But in a way, that's good because, like I said, especially for me, I feel like that challenges people to grow. And I feel like with professors not going to be able to hold my hand, it helps me become more independent and accountable, not just for myself, but for others.
At least it's gradual. I mean, you go from elementary school where they're holding your hand constantly to like college where they're not really holding your hand anymore, but you've been slowly broken in.
And you'll be ready.
Your responsibility. But
luckily, you have quite a while before you even have to think about that. So with that being said, just enjoy it, you know. Really, this is your first last quarter of a school year for high school. So that's cool. But yeah, just enjoy it, you
know.
I'm
kind of ready for summer break.
See?
Like, I know we just got back.
Oh, yeah.
Spring break, I'm ready. I'm so ready for summer break.
And that's great. I am contemplating summer break. Not because I don't want it, but because the reality that I am about to be a college student is going to hit so much more. But with that being said, and not just for me, but for everyone, that's all the more reason why, you know, we should really enjoy this last quarter that we all have together and truly make the most of it. And use the previous quarters as a reflection, but don't let it dictate and control your fourth quarter, at least in a negative way. Use past quarters as a learning experience, but live to the fullest in your fourth quarter. And just have fun, let go. Still be an academic scholar, but let go. We're in a final push, you know, let your hair down a little, but still work hard.
Thank you all for listening today. We will catch you next time.
Bye, guys.
Podcast. This is the Cristo Rey Podcast.
Whoa, it's that crazy blue light again. That can only mean...
Hold on, thank you for dear life and... Wait, I quantum leaped again? Didn't I?
That's right, future Emily. I know how this works now. You've quantum leaped from the future, just like in the critically acclaimed classic sci-fi drama Quantum Leap that aired on NBC from 1989 to 1993 starring Scott Bakula, or like the revived series starring Raymond Lee that ended its second season a few weeks ago. In fact, it's been exactly 31 days since a new episode. 31
Mr. Corrigan,
days? What kind of format is this?
Mr. Corrigan!
Sorry, Emily. Oh, okay. It's time to spill it. The first time you time traveled from the future, you gave me this key. What is the deal with this key?
That key. I wish I had never seen that stupid key. Wait, what's the day?
March 22nd, 2024.
The Friday after spring break. First week of the fourth quarter. Wow. How does that feel like so long ago now? Okay, so I'm not home. This is bad. Like, really bad. Am I just going to randomly leap again? Rufus would know.
Randomly leap? Oh, no, 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 not this time. Every time you leap from the future, you leap away before anyone from the podcast sees you. No one ever believes me. Well, not this time. Emily! Emily! Emily, come here!
Hey, Mr. Corrigan, what's going... What the... Is that me? Hello. This is a trick, right? Wow, she looks just like me. Looking good, girl.
No, you look good.
No, you,
no,
look,
you
good.
Look good. No,
you really think
actually,
so?
You
love
look
the
good.
Haircut.
No, you look
I know,
incredible,
I love your
girl.
Haircut.
Don't ever
oh,
say
I love
anything
your glasses.
About yourself.
Oh my
no,
gosh,
I think
I
you look
how great
gorgeous.
I look
good you're
without
a strong,
glasses.
Beautiful.
Oh my gosh,
woman.
Your hair is so
No,
your
Emily.
Outfit's so cute.
Emily.
Your boots are awesome.
Emily, please.
Sorry.
Emily, this proves what I've been saying. I keep getting visited by future versions of you, see?
It won't work, Mr. Corrigan. She won't believe you.
Why not?
Because I didn't believe you when I was her. She'll just think it's an April Fool's Day joke. Even though
it's
too early
for
April
Fool's
Day.
Day.
Jinx, you owe me a Coke. I was right. You should never meet your younger self. So immature.
How rude.
Oh no, I'm going to leave again. I can feel it. Here it comes!
Special effects are pretty impressive. You almost had me there.
Emily, I swear you it's true. That was you from the future.
Sure, sure, Mr. Corrigan. Whatever you say. Good gag. It really inspires me, you know. Just you wait and see what I have planned for my senior prank. I was going to keep it simple, but now I'm really going to step it up. It's going to blow what you just did out of the water. I promise. See ya.
Emily! Emily! Oh man, I can't believe it. And what's worse is, I still don't know what this future key is for. Future Emily seemed a little different this time, didn't she? Almost panicked. Was she in trouble? Speaking of trouble, did present-day Emily say something about a senior prank? Uh-oh, I should probably hide and check my classroom and my car and my... Anyway, I gotta run. I'll see you next week on the Cristo Rey Podcast. I hope.